right, we're on Kelim Perek Yud Chet Mishnah Aleph. First Mishnah in the 18th chapter of Masechet Kelim. So we're going to talk about, remember we learned that Shida, Teva, and Amigdal, all these huge, very huge things, if they're Arba'im Sa'ah Belach, if they're like 40 Sa'ah, if they're very, very large, then they're not considered Mekabel Tumah because they're not movable when they're full. They're not considered movable when they're full. What do we say? We said it's 40 Sa'ah Belach, that's 2 Kor B'Yavesh. And we said that amount was if it was, the Bar Tanura says, oh, here we are, Arba'im Sa'ah Belach, Shein Kurayim B'Yavesh, Ama Al Ama Berum Shalosh Amot. One by one, the height of 3 Amot. Okay, so now, the question is how you measure it. So I just want to share with you. I saw it, so like you said, who makes stuff that big? So I saw this article on Yisrael Hayom, just like, I'll move myself over, a crazy article about this archaeologist who is working. She's actually working on they do spectral electromagnetic scanning to see what kind of food or wine or beer was inside. But look at the size. These are the size of the beer vats that were in the Roman era, beer and wine, they would ship from Italy and these huge, 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 huge things. So, like, is that 3 amot? Is that 3 amot by 1? It looks pretty, pretty close. That's a, you know, how much you would hold. So maybe it's not Mekabel Tumah. And they also figured out how to make beer the way it tasted in ancient times. Pretty cool if you ask me. Ariel University, look it up. Okay, so the Shida, though, a Shida is a chest. And that's a Shida. So it had a lip around it, it had a frame, and it also had legs. All right, just to be more precise, it's not a chest, it's like one of these like handheld chariots that you ride in. You can see like there's like a chair, I think that's what they're describing. Because the reason we're gonna learn this is because it's gonna have like a wagon that, you know, they put it on because nobody wants to carry it the whole time. And we're gonna learn about the wagon in the next Mishnah. But it's like, I think that's, if you look, it's like this handheld, this like sort of handheld thing that you ride in. So the question is, when you measure, do you include the lip and do you include the legs? That's the nature of our machloket. Beit Shammai amim nidedet bibifnim. Beit Shammai says you measure it, you mean you measure the value, you measure that arba'im sa'ah from the inside. You don't include the walls. Beit Hillel amim nidedet bibachutz. Beit Hillel says no, you include, you measure it outside. Okay, you measure from, you know, including av ovia defano bashulayim. That's Beit Hillel hakol modedim. You measure the whole thing, but Modim Elu Elu, both Beit Shammai and Beit Hillel, according to the Tanakhama, agree, She'en Ovi Abaglayim Ovi Lizbizim Nimdad. You don't include the legs, the thickness of the legs, and the space in between them, of course, or the thickness of the Lizbizim, the Lizbez is the crowning, the framing above, not framing, it's like the molding, as it were. Okay? Rabbi Yossi, Omer says, Rabbi Yossi, no, Modim She'ovi Abaglayim Ozbi Alizbizim Nilva Nimdad. No, the thickness of the legs and the lizbez is measured, okay? But beinehem enom nimdad. But you don't measure in between them. Meaning, according to Rabbi Yossi, I made you a little chart, okay? Everyone agrees. All three opinions say the machloket is whether you measure. Beit Shammai says you measure the internal, the volume that it holds. Beit Hillel says you measure the whole thing, the size including the walls. But and Rabbi Tanakhama says you don't measure any of the other stuff. Rabbi Yossi says no. They agree that you do measure the lizbizim, but not in between them. Third opinion, let's go back to our Mishnah. Rabbi Shimon Shizuri, or Rabbi Shimon says, no, ima yuraglaim gvoho tefach en benem nindad. Depends. How big are the legs? If the legs are a tefach tall, right, then yes, then you don't measure in between them. But im lav benem nindad. If you look at the legs, if the legs are very wide, very tall, you don't measure in between them. But if not, if they're tiny, they're stumpy, then you do measure measure the inside. You wouldn't measure the thickness of them according to Beit Shammai, but you would measure the inside, and Beit Hillel, you would measure the outside of the legs themselves as well. And that we include in our chart. Imay reglaim vo tefach, then you don't. Im lav, meaning if they are not a tefach, then in between would be measured. Stop here and dedicate. I'm learning to remember my father, Harab Simcha Ben Yitzchak Kalman. Make it a great day.